think helped fuel Randle's game more?
I'm not sure, honestly. But he came out and he was really good early on. And he was active on defense, which is what I was most impressed and happy with. It feels like every time he has one of these big games, he starts the game making plays for us on the defensive end. You know, it started, one of the big games he had was at Atlanta. He had like 3 blocks that game. I thought he was great in putting pressure on the other team's point guards all night. And then the shots, again, they're going to fall some nights or not. And we'll take it, obviously, but more impressed with the way he got after it defensive tonight.
He seemed to tinker with the rotation a little bit. Was that situational, just how the game was flowing?
I didn't feel like we got in a great flow tonight. Obviously, we'll take a win, and Brooklyn's a good team. They never stop coming at you. But it didn't feel like the way we've been playing as far as sharing the ball and having fun and making the extra pass. Just felt a little off tonight, so I was trying to manipulate in whatever way I could to get us back to playing a certain way.
That second unit that you have been playing with, Tarek and Nance, Ingram, Lou, Clarkson, has seemed to just push your lead ahead, and they just didn't seem to.
They've been great all year, so obviously we're not going to complain about them. But even before the game, I said I think the reason they have so much success is because of how unselfish they play as a group. And they get after it defensively, and then that ball just moves to the open man. And tonight it didn't feel like that for whatever reason. But, it's one game, and like I told our guys, it's really hard to win in this league. So to find a way to still win and take care of your home court, we'll take it.
On the opposite side, was it then good to see the other starting five and that unit kind of do what you've been looking for?
Yeah. They were better tonight. Like I said, I thought it started with D'Angelo's defense, and then obviously he hit a couple shots and got in a rhythm. But they were good tonight to start the game and to start the second half. So it was good to see that. Obviously, watch the tape tonight and know more about it tomorrow.
We've talked about Julius Randle.
Well, he's continuing to get better, I think, and really realize what he's capable of doing. And as good as he played tonight, there's probably 9 or 10, 11, 12 times where he didn't get himself involved in the play, whether it wasn't, getting all the way back on defense, not plugging the paint on help side drive. So, I mean, his ability to create for others, to get to the rim, and now he's starting to hit that mid-range jumper a little more consistently. He's figuring out, and I think starting to believe in what he can really do in this league. But we need more in every type of possession mentality, and not just from him, from all our guys. We have a habit of taking plays off, especially when things are going good for us. We kind of get in a mindset of like, all right, well, we're going to keep scoring, and we let up on the defensive end. But obviously, he was pretty dang special.
You mentioned a couple times his belief in what he can do. Like, how much of that? How important is that for a young guy?
It's huge because it's his rookie year. He didn't play at all. He broke his foot. So last year was really his first year. And, there's one thing to be able to do stuff in practice and in real work. But to get it to translate into NBA games is tough. And, I think he's, figuring out that, when is a good time to attack the rim for himself and when it's a good time to attack, and he sees that defense collapsing and he can find his shooters. And when we're playing unselfish and we're playing at the pace we want to play at, it puts a lot of pressure on the defense when Julius is coming full speed at him and they don't know if he's going to look to score or look to play make for a shooter.
You haven't been apprehensive about letting Brandon close out games or
What are you seeing from him that gives you that confidence to put him on that clutch?
He's a winner. He really is. And we saw that early on in training camp and summer league. His team, you know, he finds ways to win in drills. And, you know, he's not afraid of the moment. He's got a great feel for the game. You know, defensively, he's getting a lot better defensively, and I think he's another one that we need to get it more consistently from. But down the stretch of games, he's almost getting to the point where he's a lockdown defender with that length and you know, feel for the game and read of what's happening. You know, he had a huge defensive play, not just the block, but they were in transition and he jumped at one of their players bringing it, and you know, he came out of nowhere and the guy ends up throwing the ball out of bounds and stopping a transition that could have ended up in a three or a dunk. So he's constantly proven and earned the trust to be out there at the end of the game.
Is that feel for the game, is it ahead of the curve in terms of what?
Yeah, for 100%. He's, for his age, playing 1 year of college basketball, you know, the way he sees the game and the way he reacts to things when he's really engaged, it is pretty impressive.
Before you put Ingram back in for crunch time, you looked like you had a couple words with him on the sideline.
Yeah.
What was that about, if you don't mind?
I just told him he had Lou open on a swing pass, and he kind of took a contested three. And, you know, I know he wants to be great, which we want. We want him to be aggressive, but we also want him to make the right play. And in that scenario, in that situation, and knowing how well he feels and sees the game, I'm fairly confident that he saw Lou open on that swing pass. But, you know, at the time he hadn't gotten many touches, so, you know, I'm sure he wanted to get some shots up himself. You know, he's pretty good scorer. But, you know, we had that talk, and then he went back in, and he played great down the stretch.
Is that a sub just to have that conversation?
Yeah, he would have probably stayed in longer if that wasn't the case, but you know, I felt like at that point it was, you know, rather than call a timeout, which we might need down the stretch, it was the best way to make the team perform.